overview of Xert. So when you log in, you have a bunch of different things you can click on here. Before I get into this and show you all of it, everything is based on how you set it up. So if you click on goals, I don't know why this is like that. Freshness feedback. So this is sort of an additional thing you can do, but the main thing you need to do, the main things you need to do are pick an athlete type. So right now I have it on triathlete because I just want to do base stuff. That's 3 hour power. But you can see all of the ones that are available, all the way from 20 seconds up to 3 hour power. You want to pick a target event date. I just set this as the first of the year. Now that I know I need to work backwards from December, I may actually change this so that this base period ends. But it doesn't really matter too much because I'm just doing base right now. And then the improvement rate, you can do, you know, you can set it to taper the last week. Maintenance would just be sort of to maintain your current CTL or training load. Slow is 1, an improvement rate of 1, ramp rate of 1. This is 2. That's where I have it set. I don't want to ramp too fast only because I'm going to run out of headroom. Since I'm already at around 13 hours a week, I can't really add a great deal. You would probably want to set it at one of these two, I think, and just take your time building. You can use these other ones. They recommend using these if you want to do some sort of like really big overcompensating week or something like that, where you want to really hit yourself hard and see if you can eke out a little bit before resting. But the whole idea here is with the moderates, slow, moderate 1, maybe even moderate 2, you really don't need rest weeks. You just go with it, and it is possible to just continue to build without rest weeks. When you set all this up, then it'll tell you, you know, how much you're going to average over this period, how much threshold is projected to go up over 6 weeks, etc. Then once you have it set up, when you log in, you'll get sort of this screen. It'll tell you, this is your athlete type right here, triathlete for me. This is sort of related to CTL. So I'm basically 5 stars would be 150. I think I'm at 120 right now, so I'm like 4.5. This tells you your last breakthrough, the last time your fitness signature changed. That was 1 week ago for me. Threshold power, high intensity energy. This is sort of your ability to go, how much you can exert over threshold, spend down, your peak power. Then this will change depending on your athlete type. This suggests that I can do 225 watts for 3 hours. 3 hours is the corresponding duration for a triathlete. I think that's wrong. I don't think there's any way I could hold 225 for 3 hours, but maybe it doesn't have enough data. And then this is lower threshold power. This is sort of a big thing with Xert. It's sort of defined as the power you can hold indefinitely. I think this is probably actually closer to 3 hour power for me. So working backwards, if you look at rankings, this will tell you, I have it set to all genders, past, if I want to look at year to date, where I fit in. So you can see that, and I'm going to do better on the ones that are watt per kilogram. Some of these are just pure power. But this will tell you sort of where you rank compared to the other people in Xert. So that's sort of interesting to look at. The progression is going to give you all of the charts that you might see in Training Peaks or WKO. If I set this for a year to date, it'll tell me sort of numbers here, but then I can change. This is sort of the curve that you would see in WKO, but you can add other things like threshold power. You can see where the breakthroughs were, how it's changed over time. You can see it kind of dropped with my training load here all the way down to 238. Now it's back up to the mid, sort of high 240s. You can get rid of some of this stuff and add other stuff. You can see how much XSS you've done per day, over time, etc. But you can also look at your fitness signatures. So this is what I was saying earlier. If you look at your lower threshold power and threshold power, they're going to track pretty much. So if you can build lower threshold power, you can see I've had it as high as 206, maybe. You should be building threshold as well at the same time. So it's a way to hit threshold without doing that high, that sort of really tough workout. Another thing that Steve talked to me about was this lower training load. So if you can build lower training load over time, they sort of track as well. So the more you can do, the more load you can build below threshold, that's basically your aerobic system, and you can build as you, if you build that, you should be building threshold at the same time. So that's, there's more here, but that's enough. And then the planner will allow you to actually, you can actually like get in here and click this, and you can schedule a week if you want. I typically don't do that because I want to choose based on what it gives me and how I feel. I want a little bit of freedom to choose the workout I do for each day rather than just having it set it. But what is interesting here is this yellow, and it can actually get to red. I'm not sure where the information is related to the stars, but generally this can get as dark as red. So yellow means that you're tired, and that is associated with your high intensity system. So basically, while this is yellow, I'm not going to get stuff above threshold. It's not going to prescribe stuff above threshold. So the earliest I might see a workout that involves more high intensity stuff would be Sunday, based on where I'm at right now. So it'll be Sunday before I get something that hits my high energy system. And then training, this is basically where you hang out most of the time. The other stuff is good to know about, but typically this is where you're at. So training will give you, this is the adaptive training advisor, so it tells you your deficit as of today. So I'm at 83, even though I worked out already this morning. I'm trying to catch up because I had it at slow, the improvement rate, and I upped it to moderate one, so I'm trying to catch up. Tells you the phase, what the focus is for this phase, the interval targets. So this is typically going to be, especially when you're in the base phase, it's going to be right at lower threshold power. Workout goal and the difficulty, this can go up to 5 stars. So it says you're in a base phase, etc. You have a training deficit of this, which is going to require this much time or this many activities, etc. And you can kind of go through, you can see it's going to increase my duration over time. I'm going to end up right at around 16 hours in January, although I'm not going to complete all of this just because I'm going to actually start this over again in December based on a target date of April 17th for a Barry. And then these are the workouts it recommends based on this status. There are several here. These are all threshold or below. And you can load more. So it's got a bunch of options. And then this button, this ZWO button, that's how. So if, let's say, I wanted to do, I really don't want to do any of these right now because my legs hurt, but let's say I wanted to do this one. I could just download the ZWO file, click on that. It'll download, walk this way. And then if I go to the Finder, to my downloads, you can see I've downloaded a bunch, but here are some of the ones I've downloaded. In fact, I've downloaded this one before. This is a ZWO file. You don't want the ERG file. ERG will not run, but the ZWO file will. And then on the Mac anyway, if you go to Documents, there is a Zwift folder, and there's a workout folder in the Zwift folder, and then some random number. And this is where you put, so you can see I have Falling Water, Kick into the Middle. These workouts, if I open up Zwift, It will, you can see that these are the workouts that will be in my workout folder when I get in there. So if I skip connecting to all of the devices and just go right to the training folder, hopefully this will load. Here it goes, I'm logging in. So I see if I skip this, just so you can see the training. All right, here are these, see falling water, kick it in the middle. These are in, they're in the custom workout folder. You can see they're the same thing that I see in this folder. So that's how that works. Let me get out of Zwift because it's gonna So that's how you select workouts. Now, like for instance, today I already worked out. I worked out fairly hard. I don't want to do something that's sort of meaty, like tempo, sweet spot stuff. I'm not sure my legs want to do that. You can go and look at the workouts. When you look at the workouts, there's the standard workouts. There's personal workouts, and then there's coach workouts. You can join a community where people sort of create workouts and make them available to the public. But typically you can go in here and sort based on how difficult they are. So there is some active recovery stuff in here. You can sort it by XSS or by the focus. So it's gonna, this is alphabetical. So breakaway specialist, I think is 2 minute power, etc. So that's basically it. I guess the sync. I don't have it set up to sync with Strava, but if you do connect with Strava, then you have to select the type of workouts. So if I do this, just so you can see. So now, what you do is you select the type of workouts that you want to get pulled over from Strava. So I have this set up weird because I was just going to pull up additional like weight training, etc., and have my bike sync from Garmin. But you basically would come in here and probably select, let's see, virtual ride. And where's in a ride? So if you just want your cycling stuff to come over, those are the two you'd probably pick out. I'm not going to do this because I don't pull it from Strava. I guess the final thing is there's a power curve here. You can see your fitness signature, what you can do for various durations. So that's just like WKO as well, and you can actually plug in stuff here and see how it would change, etc. All right, that's it.